the bad guys, and you're a Kree, a race of noble warriors.
Noble warrior heroes.
Welcome to the red carpet world premiere of Marvel Studios, Captain Marvel. I'm Lorraine Singh.
And I'm J.D. Heyman. Super excited to be here. The most exciting spot in the galaxy, I think, tonight.
I know, and definitely in Hollywood. We're here on Hollywood Boulevard, waiting for all of the stars to come join us here on the red carpet and have an incredible night.
It's going to be really exciting. We have some kids here from the Boys and Girls Clubs of Los Angeles, County Alliance over there. Proud members of the U.S. Air Force over here, and some incredible fans of the Marvel Universe on this side.
I know, and if you're not already, go head over to marvel.com/Captain Marvel Live to watch this live stream and check out all kinds of photos and articles and other cool stuff, or go over to Facebook/Captain Marvel Official or @Captain Marvel and interact with us all night using the #CaptainMarvel.
That's a lot.
It
is
a lot.
You can also watch it on people.com and EW.com. Really exciting.
There are so many ways to watch, and we have so much going on because we're not just here. We're down the carpet as well with some of our friends, Tamara Krinsky and Angelique Roche. How are you girls doing down there?
We are doing great. Thank you so much. Great to see you, JD and Lorraine. We are midway down the carpet. It's a massive carpet because we are going to see members of the extended Marvel Universe. It's always a party here at a Marvel premiere.
Yeah, you really never know what's going to happen, and we're really excited to be down the carpet. We're also excited that we're going to be talking to some of the Marvel family here who are here to commemorate such an amazingly groundbreaking film.
And we also want to give a shout out to Marvel Contest of Champions. Thank you so much for presenting this live stream to you, the fans, so that we can share every moment of what's happening here on the carpet tonight.
Absolutely, and there are going to be some incredible moments. I know that we're going to be talking to some of the cast and crew from Marvel's Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., mm-hmm. as well as some folks from Marvel's Cloak & Dagger.
Absolutely, and maybe even Marvel Rising, so you never know who's going to show up. This movie has such a special place in so many people's hearts. Lorraine, I know it's near and dear to you, J.D. as well.
Oh, Carol is such an important character to me, proud member of the Carol Corps. And I know that everyone wants to see more of this film, so why don't we take a special look at Marvel Studios' Captain Marvel right now.
So, Skrulls are the bad guys. And you're a Kree, a race of noble warriors.
Heroes, noble warrior heroes.
Your life began the day it nearly ended. We found you with no memory. We made you one of us so you could live longer, stronger, superior. You were reborn.
I keep having these memories. Something in my past is the key to all of this.
You know how to fly this thing?
We'll see.
That's a yes or no question.
Yes.
To know what you really are.
I think I had a life here. What aren't you telling me?
You've come a long way, but you're not as strong as you think. This war is just the beginning.
I'm not gonna fight your war. I'm gonna end it.
Aren't you the cutest little thing? Aren't you cute? And what's your name, huh?
Fury.
I'll be back.
are back. Look at who we found right here with us, Anna Boden and Ryan Fleck, our directors, co-writers. Hello.
The geniuses behind this film. So what is it like to go through this journey, and now you're standing here on the red carpet in the middle of Hollywood? Did you ever think you'd make it to this point?
It's surreal. We're still not sure we've made it to this point. It's all a dream.
You're not hallucinating. We're really here. It's happening.
This is real life happening right now. Carol Danvers is such a beloved character, but I'm wondering for you guys, what attracted you to being part of this amazing film?
It's her messiness and her humanness. And when we heard that Brie Larson was cast in the role, that was such a draw for us because we knew that she would bring that humanity to such a powerful, strong, confident character, and that she could bring all the vulnerability and the messiness that we love in all of our characters.
I love that.
With Carol Danvers, especially, that messiness is so core to who she is as a hero. You've done really complicated, sometimes really unhappy people and brought them on screen. Is it hard to weave in all of the superhero-ness of it all, or do you just stay focused on the character?
No, I mean, when you're surrounded by actors like Brie Larson and Sam Jackson, I mean, they do so much of the work, and they bring so much history, and they bring so much life to these parts that really it's just we can kick back and just watch most of the time. It makes our jobs really easy. Every now and then we have to give some direction, but it's mostly fun.
Yeah, you know, you guys and Brie Larson, you guys have done a ton of indie film. What has it been like stepping into, I mean, the Marvel Universe is huge. What has it been like stepping into that?
Surreal and amazing, but you know, just watching Brie Larson take on this role and turn herself into like a jock for this role, is becoming so strong.
Pushing Jeeps.
We all saw her push that Jeep up the hill, didn't we? Google it if you haven't. We were just the only thing that surprised us is that she didn't actually come on set shooting photon blasts one day.
Of all the things you got to do, what was the biggest kick for you? I mean, what was the most outrageous scene for you, the thing that made you most excited to try to do as filmmakers?
I think shooting on a moving LA Metro train and like actually staging a fight on a moving train was pretty awesome. And then having Brie do like a flip onto the top of a train and shoot photon blasts out of her hand. I mean, not actually like Anna said, but like she came close. That was pretty surreal.
Yeah, I love that you guys chose Kelly Sue DeConnick's run on the comic book as some of your inspiration. What were the key components that you felt that she brought to the character?
Her humor, first of all, just leaning into her humor and that certain edginess that her character has, but also the female relationships. I mean, she did such a good job painting these amazing female relationships with her own peers that could be loving, but also competitive and fierce. And then also young girls who she was inspired and older mentors who had inspired her.
Yeah, all kinds of women.
Yeah, I mean, one of the most exciting things about Captain Marvel is the devotion of her fans. And Carol Kore, people are really into it. Did you draw from the fans? Did you take inspiration from them? Did you feel that, you know, the pressure to deliver something that they would love?
Yeah, there's a little pressure, but I think we just wanted to stay as true to the character that they love and that we also love, and that hopefully they'll come along on the ride with us and feel it too. And they're awesome. They're like, they're the best, most devoted hardcore fans.
Yeah, we have the best fans in the whole darn world on this earth. Earth's mightiest fans, thank you so much.
Thank you, guys.
Enjoy the night and congratulations.
Thank you.
I just think that it really is. Look at the amazing fans all around us.
The best fans in several galaxies.
In all of the galaxies. Yes. And, you know, that's what this film is really going to do, too, is explore not only Earth, but the great beyond.
The great beyond. This is a great movie for exploring multiple universes within the Marvel Cinematic Universe, bringing together characters and heroes that have never encountered each other before.
True.
But tonight they will, and I think that the fans are going to be super excited to see what these filmmakers have done with these beloved characters.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, the thing that I really love about Carol Danvers, I am an intense comic book fan, and Carol Danvers was born in 1968, and she really was a huge part of the women's liberation movement. Her name originally was chosen because she embodied this new thing. Oh my gosh, Jonathan, hello. Hey. Universe for so long. You've been kicking around. What is it like to see 10 years of growth?
It's been pretty amazing. When I first joined Marvel, it was a very small office without very many people, and it was very, very early days. And to sort of be along for the ride and watch what it's become and see the group of people that we started with sort of stick around and build the cinematic universe into what it is today has been inspiring and amazing and a journey like nothing I could have imagined.
So you've been here since the very first premiere. It must be gratifying to see people dressed as the characters. Could you have ever imagined there'd be this whole legion of people who come out and really identify with the dreams that you guys have managed to render and put on screen?
I think we always hope that people would. I think you never sort of allow yourself to kind of dream that big. But it's been really gratifying to see people kind of latch onto these characters and respond to this universe in the way that we always love those characters and we always love the comic book universe. To kind of get to share that vibe and share that dream with so many people has been the thrill of a lifetime.
Well, thank you so much. Congratulations on the night. Enjoy the film tonight.
Good talking to you.
Cheers.
Thanks so much.
I mean, 10 years going on 11.
Going on 11
it's
years.
It's been a lot of films. I believe this is our 22nd Marvel Cinematic Universe film.
22 films. And, of course, if you think about it, going way back, think of the number of superheroes that have been introduced mm-hmm. to a broader audience than even the large audience mm-hmm. of Marvel Comics. It's, you know, in an international force, an intergalactic force, I think.
Indeed. And speaking of our far satellites, Angelique and Tamara, who you got down there?
We have London Fuller, who plays our youngest Carol Danvers. Welcome tonight. So I have to ask you, what happened to your foot?
Well, as you can see, I forgot that I didn't have superpowers, and I pulled my 58-pound dog up the stairs.
Maybe you need to talk to Brie and get some training trips from her.
Yeah.
Well, tonight is a really big night, and we know that you had a blast putting together this movie. What do you feel like this night? And for you, what does this mean, being a young woman?
It feels to me like I'm, like, not the only girl who has strong powers. Every girl around the world has strong powers. And it's just a super, super good opportunity for me to be here right now.
Well, we are so happy to have you joining us here at the premiere. You have a fantastic time tonight, and congratulations on the movie.
Thank you. Thank you.
All right, have a wonderful time. Thank you. Bye. Bye. I love the fact that we get to see so many different parts of Carol Danvers' life in this movie.
That is the whole core of the movie, right? This is a journey. This is a journey.
The Carol core. Sorry, couldn't resist.
I love it. But it really is a journey. It's an amazing journey through the entire life mm-hmm. of Carol Danvers. And that starts really young.
It starts very, very young. And we have so many people here who are excited yeah. to come and see this. I think we've got some Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. who may be joining us in a moment.
I do believe we do have some Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D.
Yeah.
I know that right to our left, hopefully coming very soon, we have Chloe Bennett, Elizabeth Henstridge, coming over here, like literally Dr. Jemma Simmons.
Oh, yeah.
And the Quake.
Well, while we're waiting for them to quake their way on over, let's check out what Lorraine and JD are up to.
So we're lucky enough to be
here with
a slightly older young Carol Danvers, McKenna Grace. What a dress. Incredible. You're so excited
Thank
you to
so
be
much.
Here, huh?
I am. This is like one of the most exciting moments of my life.
Oh, my God. Okay, what are you looking forward to doing tonight here on the carpet?
Everything. Anything that I get to do, I'm super excited to do.
Now, I know that you worked with Chris Evans before. We call him Captain America around here. Yeah. I'm curious, did he give you any hints about the Marvel Cinematic Universe?
Well, it was a little bit ago, but I don't believe so, but...
You were on your own.
I mean, but I'm just a really big fan, so whenever I did get to work with him, my dad's over there, but we're both huge fans, so whenever I did get to work with him, it was just like, whoa.
The coolest.
Yes.
Now, you get to play a superhero as a young girl.
Yes.
What do you want other girls your age to take away from this film?
You can do anything you put your mind to. And... and just to follow your dreams.
You know, and I think it's very impressive. We get to see in the trailer that you always get back up and you dust yourself off. Where do you think that Carol, as a girl, starts to find her strength?
I mean, I think that she was always so strong. But I don't know. I honestly don't know, but I think that she's just always had this strength inside of her, and it just bursts out, and she's just this super awesome, powerful female superhero.
I agree with you completely. She does. She finds it in herself.
She's a strong character, and she's got a lot of grit. In terms of what you got to do, what was the coolest thing you got to do or experience while you were making this film?
Oh, I want to say, I don't know if I'm allowed to say it.
No spoilers.
No spoilers. You can't spoil
it. I know.
It was really cool.
It was. It was super cool. I don't know what to say because
well, I guess
I don't want to ruin it.
Okay, I guess we'll
you know
just
what?
Have to...
No spoilers. We're gonna go over and check in on Tamara and Angelique, and we're going to get all the secrets,
you're
all right?
Whisper it to us.
They gave me an option. I chose this one. I'm gonna such a
happy camera. Hey, we are here with Elizabeth Henstridge and Chloe Bennett. Hello, ladies.
Hello. We were talking about the shoes on display, the best shoes ever.
Can you see them? Well, we get to enjoy it.
Yeah.
That's our this secrets of the carpets. So, speaking of secrets, so one of the things that is new that we get to see in Captain Marvel is Nick Fury meeting an extraterrestrial for the first time. But y'all have a lot of experience with that. I think the Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. can teach him something about that. What would be your advice to him?
You know, the advice, take a present.
Take a present?
A gift.
Oh, to meet the aliens.
Yeah. Yeah.
You can't show up at a house uninvited. I don't know if they're showing
up. Or a planet.
Up.
I just think it puts you on the right foot.
Or
say,
tentacles.
The best. Try to think the best.
The best, you know? People are different. Aliens are different. I don't know.
Present. Bring a bottle of wine. Good idea.
Much like the red carpet, you never know what you're going to get when you make first contact with aliens. Got it. Solid. Speaking of, we have a new season coming out. There are lots of things happening. Brand new trailer has dropped, coming out soon.
It did?
Yeah, it did.
Yes, it did.
The best trailer you've ever seen.
It was amazing, and you were phenomenal, and we got lots of sneak peeks into what's next for both Dr. Jemma Simmons and for Agent Daisy Johnson.
You
know, what are you most excited for fans to see in this next season?
One of the favorite episodes I've ever shot is in season 6.
Yes.
And it's a very fun one for Simmons.
Is it with Oz?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, obviously. We have a really fun episode.
Yeah, we do. It's a very inventive season writing-wise. They just did so many new things and... a lot of really cool, funny. It's very funny this
very
season.
Funny.
Oh, we hope it is.
Episode.
We found it very funny.
We couldn't stop laughing.
If you don't, then sorry.
Also, we've been holding each other
the whole time.
Entire interview.
Yeah.
Well,
this whole movie, Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., you've got many women supporting each other.
Yes.
We want to ask you more questions, but we don't want to put you in the position of spoiling anything, so we're going to let you continue heading down the carpet.
Support our careers
Thank
in that
you.
Way. Don't get inspired. Thank you.
We're here for you.
Thank you. Nice to see you.
Well, we're going to go back down to the other end of the red carpet and see what Lorraine and JD are up to.
You know, we are just hanging out here, and I got to say, we kicked off this red carpet, I think, the coolest way we ever have kicked off a red carpet.
Unbelievable, watching the Thunderbirds soar over Hollywood Boulevard. They looked close enough to touch.
They really were so close. It was 6 F-16 fighter jets. Just there you see them right there in the sky right above us. I mean, it's truly to stand under it feels thrilling.
And a real testament to our men and women from the U.S. Air Force who are here tonight supporting Captain Marvel. It's great.
It's absolutely amazing. But what else is amazing is Marvel Studios' Captain Marvel. So please take a special look at this feature.
Grunge is a good look for you.
Did you have a rough day, Agent Fury?
I'm gonna need clarification on this space invasion.
Skrulls are infiltrating your planet. They're shapeshifters.
Okay, prove you're not a Skrull.
That's a photon blast.
And?
A Skrull cannot do that.
I'm just supposed to take your word for that. We are Kree. Strong. United.
You have to let go of the past.
I don't remember my past.
Control it.
I have this power, but I don't know where it came from.
I've never seen anything like her.
You think you can find others?
She's just the beginning.
You've come a long way.
But you're not as strong as you think.
What is this?
The SHIELD logo.
Does announcing your identity on clothing help with the covert part of your job?
Said the space soldier who was wearing a rubber suit.
Get tickets now.
Look at who just popped by for a drink. Ben Mendelsohn, hello.
Hello there. Hey, Marvel fans.
Hey. We are talking to all the Marvel fans, and we are alive, so anything can happen.
So you're used to playing sinister characters. You seem to enjoy that.
Mm-hmm.
What draws you to the dark side? Why don't you just explain to us why you're so evil?
Look, if we had a little bit more time, I'd be able
We've
to
got all
go.
The time in the
but
world,
But here's
Ben.
The thing, you know, when you're the bad guy, you can always do it for the money. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Like, bad guys get paid. That's
Ooh.
Simple,
there
you know.
There you go.
Yeah, bad guys get paid. I mean, it makes a lot of sense. You know, I'm interested. You have said in a bunch of interviews that you are Skrulling. Can you define Skrulling for us?
You know, it's just kind of an attitude. It's just kind of like kick back, you know.
Skrulls are chill.
Skrulls are kind of chill with, you know, a lot of strength. You know what I mean? Like
highly adaptable as well.
Very adaptable. Lots of, you know, changing. You know, I've come in my, you know, human disguise.
Which
form.
We appreciate. We can
No,
we can
I
recognize
think it's
you.
Easier for the people at home. Less threatening, all that.
You know, I'm curious. We get to see a Skrull transformation, you know. What does that feel like for a Skrull?
It's kind of rough, but also pleasant at the same time. It's kind of like, oh, you know what I mean? It's like weird kind of electric, funky shocks going on. So it's uncomfortable, but it's also kind of like, oh, that's good. But changing back, very refreshing, you know?
Yeah, sort of like an all-body massage. You just
a big, long drink of water, something like
there
that.
We
like,
go.
Oh, there it is. I'm back Skrulling, you know?
Just back to Skrulling.
So you've been part of another cinematic universe. Playing,
indeed.
You got a cool cape. You got blown to bits. Now you're in this universe.
Yeah.
What's exciting about joining all these Marvel characters? And what drew you to it? And why are you excited to be part of it?
Look, it's a really beautifully written script. I had worked with the directors Anna Boden and Ryan Fleck before in a film called Mississippi Grind. So we knew each other well. Look, people love these films, and I'm pretty confident that we've made a really beautiful film that people are going to dig.
Well, I'm confident as well. There are so many people that want to talk to you tonight, so thank you for stopping by and speaking with us.
Victoria, JD, it's a pleasure.
Just try to stay in your human form for the evening.
I'm going to do my best, but no promises.
Skrull's got a Skrull.
Skrull's got a Skrull.
That's what I've learned. All right, let's see what's going on with Tamara and Angelique. What trouble are you ladies getting into over there?
We are getting into lots of trouble because we have some Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D. here. We're so happy to be bringing all of this to you guys, the fans, presented by Marvel Contest of Champions.
One of the cast members, but he's not fully an agent yet, I have to say.
Oh. That's exactly. That's up for debate. You know,
we all
got to talk about that.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I feel like Deke has the heart for it.
Oh. I appreciate that. I think so, too. I think he's, you know.
And the pedigree.
Hopefully.
Yeah.
Hopefully. Yeah. Yeah, that's exactly right.
Yeah.
Being a Fitzsimmons, come on, it gets you in the door, doesn't
yeah.
it?
Yeah.
Are you going to take on the Fitzsimmons last name? Do you think that's going to be part of your journey?
I mean, I would, but then, like, I'd have to be closer associated to Ian. And, you know, that's, like, not really
my
style.
You know, Ian and Fitz are two different people.
Yeah, no, Fitz I like. Ian I can't stand.
Right. Yeah. We're all in agreement there.
Yeah, exactly.
It's good to see that after 5 seasons together, well, you, now it's going into 2, you're kind of figuring it out.
I know.
You're in your sophomore year.
Can you believe it? I know. It feels like it's like a nice S.H.I.E.L.D. campus that we have.
Actually, for real, it's like the only thing that shoots at the studio now. So it's like,
like S.H.I.E.L.D. University.
It's great.
Yeah, it's fantastic.
Well, we're really glad that you made it off of S.H.I.E.L.D. University to make
Thank
it
you.
Here onto the red carpet.
Thank
I know
you.
We were just talking about how empowering this is and yes. it's such a critical moment. How are you feeling being here on the red carpet tonight?
Well, I got my 90s crimped hairdo. And I just love the logo that they have when they're flashing her and then Hero comes in. It's like just, it's so empowering for all the women, the girls that are going to be watching this movie.
And I have to say, you know, to be here with Ming-Na also, who's one of those original people who is, you know, kicking butt on TV.
I'm an original like, person. Really,
no, well, you're, you know, like being one of those like incredible female heroes, like, you know, Aww. You're... You're one of those OGs, so it's
well,
really cool.
We'll let y'all finish hanging out a little bit,
Thank
and you.
You
definitely continue to compliment Ming-Na.
That's all I do is walk around S.H.I.E.L.D. University complimenting Ming-Na.
Yeah, but, well, you know, it costs a lot.
Well, we're going to go ahead and toss it back over to the other side of the carpet and see what Lorraine and J.D. have up over there.
Have fun, Lorraine and J.D.
Well, we've got the Scandinavian weather you for you. It's Rune Temte, who is making his debut, the first Norwegian to be in the Marvel
MCU,
Universe.
Yeah.
Thor is Scandinavian, but we don't know his papers.
He was kind of Scandinavian, yeah.
Kind of, sort of, but he's from Asgard.
Great. Yeah, exactly.
So, Bronchar is on the Star Force. What kind of position does he hold? What is his, like, skill set?
I mean, Bronchar, he has the powers of beating up anyone and anything and, you know, taking care of everything he can get hold of, really. And hitting them hard and with all his powers. So that's basically it.
Now, we should say the Star Force is pretty intense. There are a lot of intense, strong members of that particular unit. Who would you not want to go up against in a battle? Between members of the Star Force?
Oh, you know, we've been doing so much fighting together to get to that level, the Star Force, obviously. So I think we are, I don't know, to be up against the swords, I don't want to do that for sure.
Yeah. No swords, no zero swords. We're going to stay away from swords. You were a professional athlete, correct?
Yes, I played professional soccer back in Norway. That's, some time ago. How did you do that? It's been 20 years.
A secret teller called the internet. But, you know, I'm curious, how does that athletic training help you when you're doing these long days of battle scenes?
No, I mean, everything in this character is like something athletic. You have to be skillful and you have to have the stamina. And obviously that got to use finally. So it's great to do a character like this.
Well, I'm ready to watch you literally crush it in Marvel Studios, Captain Marvel. Thank you so much for talking with us.
And we're going to go back down the red carpet where something really exciting is happening with Citizen.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
Woo! We are here with some amazing Captain Marvel fans. This is so exciting.
Yes.
And we're going to play a game with them, but first, Josh Peck. Thank you for hanging out. I want to know why you are excited to be here tonight at the red carpet premiere for Marvel Studios Captain Marvel.
Oh my gosh. I mean, this is like Captain Marvel, totally new universe that we're getting to see. And I mean, for me, more Brie Larson all the time. Am I right, guys? Yes. The people know. They know.
Now, you are a Citizen Ambassador.
Yes.
Why did Citizen want to be involved with the Captain Marvel premiere?
Well, I think Citizen makes watches for everyone, right? Mm-hmm. So now every Marvel fan is well covered, whether it's my watch, the Marvel Heroes watch, or
my watch.
Black Panther, Hulk, Spider-Man. Every Marvel fan can find a Citizen watch for them.
All right, now we're going to, like I said, we're going to play a little game. We are going to find out what Captain Marvel really means to these fans and who the biggest Captain Marvel fan is.
So, a lot of pressure.
30 seconds to tell us and prove they are the one. You ready?
Yes.
All right, you go first. Find a fan.
Okay. Right here. We good? Yes. Yay!
All right. All time. You
okay.
go. You got 30
ready
seconds.
Ready and go.
For her being the first Marvel hero to have a solo movie as a female, and she's just empowering and passionate, and she will do what's right, and she doesn't give up, and she's just an incredible role model for girls and women all over and just people in general. And she's just absolutely wonderful.
Awesome.
Pretty great.
Yes.
That's pretty great. Way to go.
All right. I'd like to ask you, what does Captain Marvel mean to you?
Absolutely. Captain Marvel means, you know, equality between men and women. You know, she defied the odds with her dad when he said she couldn't do something. She went ahead and did it anyways because she believed in herself. And I think that's something, that positive role model that girls need and children in general need, that you can do anything that you put your mind to. And she absolutely crushed that. And, you know, the fact that she's the first female superhero in Marvel is absolutely amazing.
Awesome.
Pretty good.
Pretty good. I mean, judging from the fan noise, I think we've got two pretty even competitors.
I don't know how we're going to pick. I can't even pick where we're going to go out for dinner later. So I don't know.
Well, you know what? I say we don't decide. I say they each win.
I like that.
Yeah.
I like
and
that.
And we've got something pretty special for them. We have Citizen Marvel by Citizen. We have Marvel by Citizen Captain Marvel watches.
Yeah.
Welcome.
Come on. Come on.
Did you see the look on her face? I know.
This is your life. This is happening. Well,
thank you for speaking from the heart and sharing your love of Captain Marvel. We all share that. And now we're going to head back to the red carpet.
Yeah.
All right. We are back with Pinar Toprak, who's our amazing composer. What is it like to be part of your first Marvel Cinematic Universe big night here on the red carpet?
It's surreal. All of it is surreal. I couldn't believe that I'm a part of this film up until today. I think I'm believing it today.
So composing for a major motion picture like that is a huge, huge job. And one of the things you have to do is really know the story and make the music fit the story. Was it challenging to work? I mean, you've got 1,000 different kinds of things to learn, a lot of characters, a lot of mythology. Right. What sort of informed your making the score and how you did it?
The main thing to crack was Captain Marvel herself, her theme. And for me, anytime I approach a score, it's all about the heart. What is the heart that we're trying to connect? Because that's what music does. And after that, we came up with themes for Kree and Skrull and how to connect them all together, find the universe for the cosmic scenes as well as the fun Earth scenes. So,
well, you know, this is a little bit of a deep music nerd question, so go with me on this.
Yeah, I like this.
But, you know, like John Williams is known for like his big major fifth. Are there any like special intervals or cadences that are important to the Captain Marvel theme?
Oh, it's great that you asked me this. So, yes, it actually, the main theme starts with a minor seventh. A lot of the superhero themes are usually fourth or a fifth, and I knew that I wanted to find a theme that is recognizable from the very first two notes. So I started kind of humming ideas. That's actually how I came up with the theme. I was just humming one day. I went outside the studio, started going for a walk, and started humming this minor seventh interval, and then came up with the theme and ended up recording it on my voice memo, which is still the Captain Marvel theme, basically.
That is so cool.
So cool. The character of Carol Danvers is so complex, and you really have to convey a lot in music about her. How did you find the music in terms of what you wanted to convey? I mean, you didn't want it just a triumphal theme. You wanted to convey a little bit about her personality, and I'm wondering how you got there.
I wanted her theme to be strong and powerful, yet I wanted it to be really emotional. And because this story and how she is, there's the vulnerability, and it doesn't take away from the strength. So the key was to figure out something that is substantial and powerful. It can be really empowering, but also hopefully goes straight to your heart as well.
Well, I know it will be very empowering tonight. Congratulations and welcome to the Marvel Cinematic Universe. Thank you so much for talking with us. But you know, we are here live. Anything can happen.
Anyone can
stop by.
Anybody can stop by from any part of the world, the universe.
Hala. It's a place, but also it's fun to say.
It's a place. It's also a delicious bread product.
Oh, but you know, we have a friend stopping by
right here.
Akira
Come on
Akbar.
In.
Oh my gosh. Hello.
Hi.
So we have Akira Akbar here, who plays Monica.
Yes.
Tell us a little bit about what was your favorite moment being with all these superheroes. What did you get most excited to do? Who were you most excited to see?
I was most excited to see Brie Larson because, you know, she's one of the female superheroes, and I thought that was super cool.
That is super cool. I completely agree with you. You also got to work with Lashana Lynch. What was that like?
It was amazing. She is super nice.
Yeah. Did you guys hang out or do anything special on set?
Actually, yeah. We went to Willie's Fried Chicken in Louisiana.
Yum.
But the funny thing was, she's a vegan.
So that was awkward.
Yeah.
So you got a lot of fried chicken. What'd she have?
She had like vegan green beans.
I think vegan green beans are vegan, right?
Oh, yeah.
Are they? Unless, it depends on how you cook them,
yeah,
right?
Right.
That would be.
Right. Now you got to shoot in Louisiana. What was it like being in Louisiana?
It was kind of swampy and humid, but it was super fun. Yeah.
Good I think food. Of Louisiana as being humid, that's true, and a little swampy, and there are, you know, alligators and things like that, if you go into the wild parts. When you saw Brie for the first time, what did you guys talk about? Did you ask her about her character? Did you ask, you know, what it was like to push a Jeep?
We didn't really talk about anything, but we were just like, we had a great bond, though. Yeah.
You know, being in production, on set, long days, and I'm not going to make any judgments, but you're a littler one, so I assume, like, you need to go to sleep and do things. What do you do to keep the energy going when you're on set? Anything?
I eat candy sometimes.
Fair, fair.
What's your go-to candy?
Pixie sticks.
No, pixie sticks.
That will make you go.
A powdery snack.
Yeah.
You just pour it in there.
Yeah.
You can mainline those. So I have another question. When you found out you got this part, how did you celebrate?
Well, I didn't really celebrate, but I just screamed for a long time.
You just what?
Screamed for
a
long
time. There's a lot of screaming. And then some pixie sticks.
Yeah.
The ideal celebration, screaming and pixie sticks.
So what are you most excited to see tonight on the carpet?
I am most excited to see Brie Larson, Samuel, and Lashana Lynch.
Just hang out with your buddies again?
Yeah.
I have to compliment you on your eye makes sort of sparkly, intergalactic looking, kind of cosmic.
Yeah,
did you choose that?
No, not really.
No, someone else did.
Well, thank you so much. Enjoy the carpet tonight. We are going to look forward to seeing you up on the big screen.
Thank you so much for having me.
Our pleasure.
Enjoy the night.
Oh my gosh. I mean, what a bunch of amazing girls that are in this film. Wonderful actors in their own right and joining the Marvel Cinematic Universe. It's amazing.
I think, you know, the thing that you take away when you meet these people and when you talk to fans is just how much this story means to so many people, particularly so many women who get to see a positive hero reflected not only in the pages of a comic book, but now on the big screen. So it's really exciting.
Really, truly. Oh, I feel like there's someone getting in trouble behind us. Oh, I hear it. Hello, Lee Pace is here.
Hey, Pace. Saying hi to people.
Returning to the Marvel Cinematic Universe, welcome back.
Happy to be back. Thanks for having me.
So, you're kind of a stern, you know, tough guy on screen in these movies, but we hear that you like to dance when you're not filming.
Who told you that?
We have a supreme intelligence informs us of everything.
Yeah, I like to dance. What, are we doing it now?
Oh, yeah, we're live.
Right,
we're very live right now. We're
there
talking
we
to the Marvel fans at home across the interwebs.
Yeah,
so you
cool.
Dance party always?
Always. No, who's got the energy for that? whenever I can get one going.
Sure.
There you go. Well, so Ronan, this is 24 years in Ronan's past, potentially. What are we seeing for Ronan? How's he feeling in those early days?
I mean, you know, Ronan's not a super emotion guy, if you know what I mean. It's a much earlier version of who he is. He's not quite the fundamentalist he was when we see him in Guardians.
He's a little more laid back Ronan.
Yeah, he's a little chiller.
He's a little sort of
a little chiller
back.
Ronan.
One of the things we love about Ronan is he is the accuser.
Mm-hmm.
Right, which is a lovely descriptor for somebody. I would be the apologizer. I'm wondering if Lee Pace had a little descriptor, would it be Lee the dancer?
Oh, I no. I'm not a good dancer.
Oh. Well, that's not what we
kind
heard.
Kind of a foolish dancer. Well, who have you been talking to?
We have people that feed us secrets. We're Marvel.
Wow.
We know it all. Maybe you did it once and it just got around. I don't know what to tell you.
It just got around. Well, yeah. Well, that's good. That's a good thing to have go around about you, that you're a good dancer, that you're down to dance. That's a good one.
Do you have a good Lee Pace the?
Lee the
Oh, yeah, no, I guess I'll let other people choose that for me, right? You can earn
Lee
those
the
things.
Friendly.
Lee the Friendly. You know, my middle name is Grinner. Why don't we say Lee the Grinner?
That's a good
that's
one.
Very nice one.
That's a very good one. You know, you had to go get back in the Cree state of mind and the Cree state of blue.
Yes.
How was it being blue again? Is it sad being blue?
No, it's actually really fun. You feel like you're like a proper old Hollywood to like drive onto a studio lot, get painted blue, you know, and show up on set. And,
how long does it take you to get blue, and how long does it take you to lose the blues when you're done?
Oh, it takes, you know, hour and a half to do it, hour and a half to take it off. You know, it's pretty easy actually. Yeah.
I love that so much. Well, enjoy your another whole classic Hollywood experience on the red carpet tonight. Thank you.
Thank you.
I appreciate it.
Cheers.
Appreciate it.
I mean, I'm excited to see what Ronan is getting into.
I would call him Lee the Congenial.
Oh, very congenial.
Very congenial.
Very tall.
Very tall. That's the Cree.
That is the Cree.
They're statuesque.
very statuesque.
Very tall people. Stern often.
Stern often. You know who else is returning to the Marvel Cinematic Universe?
Who was that?
Jaimin Hansu. Who plays Karrath. We saw him in Marvel Studios Guardians of the Galaxy.
That's right. And of course, we have other people who return we see their versions of themselves when they were younger.
We do.
Nick Fury, who has two eyes.
Giving him greater depth.
Greater depth and greater depth perception.
Yes, exactly.
And then we also have Agent Coulson, who has a full head of hair.
Yeah, I mean, it's 24 years in the past. They're looking great.
They look awesome. And not that they don't look awesome.
They look
now.
Wonderful always. But, you know, I think it's really cool because we're getting this sort of origin for both of those characters. We're seeing them in their early days. The stuff that, you know, a lot of these actors, when they get their scripts, probably have to build a backstory. Well, now we're getting it, which is really cool.
Totally true. And really interesting to see these two guys, especially because, as you know, as fans know, they've encountered every matter of superhuman being, right?
Yeah.
But when they're in this film, this is the very first experience they have with a super force.
Yeah, I mean, Nick Fury has seen everything. And what I love from these the trailer is that he has a special relationship with Goose. Hello.
Oh, my goodness.
Oh, well, hello. Hello.
Well, hello.
Samuel L. Jackson is here.
Everybody
we're hanging.
Hello.
Everybody's okay.
We're just hanging out.
Cool.
How's it going?
I'm good.
Do you have any plans tonight?
Watch a movie, eat some popcorn, have some fun.
All sounds
right.
fun.
Yeah.
You know, I was just talking about your special relationship with Goose the Cat.
I don't have a special relationship with Goose the Cat.
No?
Only in the movie.
Only in the movie, not in real life.
No.
Well, Goose told me that you didn't get along, but you're both very talented actors.
Cats lie.
You know.
I found that out about them.
Is that right?
They do lie. He told people lots of stuff about me that was not true.
Well, I do know that they are indeed very catty, so I believe
yeah,
that.
Yeah, they are.
Ooh. Oh, God, I'm sorry.
So feline.
Yeah. They are.
Although, okay, we got to talk about you and Brie Larson, because I'm living for your guys' friendship. You guys have done three movies together. You seem like the best of pals. What is it like working together?
It's incredible to go to work with her. Somebody I can trust, somebody I enjoy, somebody I know is going to make what we're getting ready to do fun. And it's always one of those, we can make this seem like we've known each other forever and make this rock. See, now we got to find something where we're like mortal enemies and we don't know each other.
Ooh, I'm here for it. The sequel.
Yeah, for sure.
So you have this chemistry. Did you have it from the moment you first met her? What made you guys click?
I'm not real sure. We were sitting together at a dinner in Hawaii at the first Kong kind of gathering. And I was seated next to her, and she talked to a lot of people for a while. So she'd been there a little while longer than I had, so she knew everybody. I did not. And we eventually, you know, started talking and eating, and I ate with my fork. I chewed my food with my mouth closed. And it was all good. I didn't say anything piggish. And we were great.
And you passed. And
yeah,
now,
man.
And now you're
I
still
passed muster.
And now you're BFFs. Well, and also, we got to say, you finally don't have to wear an eye patch. Congratulations. What was it like going back to a younger Nick?
Going back to a younger Nick is kind of clearing your mind of everything that Nick Fury knows and how he feels about his job and the world and his perception of it. Just kind of being free and open. The open Nick Fury, something he's not.
You really have to look at all of these characters with fresh eyes. When we've seen you before, the superhero thing is old news to you, but now you have to look at it and be truly wowed by what you're experiencing.
Well, that's what I just said.
Yeah, then I said it again.
Yeah, it's kind of like unknowing everything that I know as older Nick Fury. But, I mean, having no idea other than, wild speculation that there might be extraterrestrials. You know, she's my first extraterrestrial. She's my first E.T., so...
Now, Brie, you've worked, obviously, on a lot of stuff together, but she's so physical in this movie. Did she impress you with the things that she could... Did you know she had that in her, that she could... I mean, she's pushing jeeps, she's lifting weights, she's really strong.
Well, I knew that before everybody else, because she was actually sending me a workout video.
Is that right?
Yeah, she was impressing me and taunting me and trying to see if I wanted to get in on some of that, and I did not. Not at all.
No. All right, that's fair. Not for you. You know, you're also reunited with Clark Gregg.
Yes.
What? Can you tease us anything about... Oh, Clark Gregg!
My name. If I hear my name, I'm going to step up
here.
There
you go. Hey, man.
Hold on. Oh, my God.
Stop.
Oh, my God. He's so handsome.
When was the last time you guys saw each other?
This morning.
This morning. Tower Records.
Yes.
Really? Just hanging out?
They reopened the tower for us. And nice. We opened the Blockbuster. We rented out a couple of movies.
Yeah.
To unsuspecting customers.
I still am paying fines that I
Yeah, own. And we shoplifted a lot.
We shoplifted a lot.
Well, oh, poor Blockbuster. Welcome back, sir.
Thank you.
Was it?
Horn in this
No.
I'm walking by.
You're here now. You can't escape us.
Okay.
It's so great to have you. And also, you guys have been here for pretty much the whole Marvel Cinematic Universe. What is it like seeing the change till now?
It's been a pretty amazing ride. I mean, I don't know, you start out at the beginning of Iron Man, you'd be insane if you tried to picture it becoming this giant a story. Yeah. And yet they've just done it so well so many times.
Yeah. You watch the evolution of the stories is really great. From the simplicity, sort of Iron Man, to the complexity of, Infinity Wars, and now, this and everything else, so it's great.
Your character, obviously, you're starting out. You look totally different than what people are used to. You're a little hairier.
Younger.
never done this before at this point. You never met all these crazy people, like he was saying. You have to unlearn what you already know when you're dealing with all these superheroes. What was the most interesting thing about being the young Agent Coulson, and how is he different from the guy we know from Agents of S.H.I.E.L.D.?
I mean, Sam said this earlier today, that it's before all that. It's before all those layers of stuff you've been through, things you know about, heartbreak. And I don't know. There's a way where I know that Coulson has been a fanboy since he was a kid, and he got himself into S.H.I.E.L.D., but I don't think he really, really deep down knows why.
I mean, all of us read comic books, I think. I mean, even Nick Fury knew of the existence of comic books, and Superman was a fantasy. Not a reality. I mean, that was nothing like that in the world, or any reason for us to believe that there really were people like that.
Well, we are ready to see the fantasy of Captain Marvel tonight. Thank you so much for talking with us. I know so many people want to talk with you.
Thanks, guys.
Right. It's so great to see you.
Appreciate it.
Take care. Always a pleasure, guys. Oh my gosh, our directors of S.H.I.E.L.D.
Oh, we had a lot.
That's the future, though. That is the future. Right now, we're just talking 90s nostalgia. And let me tell you, Marvel Studios, Captain Marvel, so much nostalgia. It is real.
It's crazy. I mean, if you go into, when you see this film, you're going to see Blockbuster Video. You're going to see payphones.
It's
pagers.
And we also know from Marvel Studios Avengers Infinity War, there was a pager with a certain symbol. That's all I'll say.
That's all. If you watched that, you knew somebody was coming.
Maybe. I don't know. We don't know.
Can't say.
But we saw a pager. But
you might have read something into that.
I don't know. But you know what? I'm here for Goose the Cat. You got to meet Goose the Cat, didn't you?
I did indeed. And now we're going to see a little encounter that I had with one of the finest actors in this cast. He might say the best actor in the cast.
Wow.
And that's Goose.
There we go.
So let's have a look.
So I've never been more excited to hit a red carpet in my life. How about you, Goose? Is that really what you're going to be wearing? What's this? Is this your... Okay, I have an idea. Just let me try this out. You're going to love this. Trust me, it's very slimming. Look at that. Now, see, you look professional. You look sort of hip, but not too fancy. You don't want to, push it too far on the red carpet. Are you ready?
Yeah, I think you're ready.
Wow, he's good. All right, Goose, it's time to have the most important conversation of the night, and that is what your favorite Marvel superhero is. Now, I figured this would be your favorite, Black Panther, because there's a whole feline connection. You know what I'm saying? Wow. How about this patriotic choice, Captain America? What do you think? Captain America? How about this, Iron Man? Great facial hair, terrific. No? You won't even look at him. Black Widow, an animal superhero, a spider. Oh, you like to play with spiders? No? Ah, it's Captain Marvel. Pretty exciting, huh? Oh my goodness, I think this is a real relationship. Yes, there's the bond that's intergalactic and filled with superpowers, right? Amazing. Goose, I wanted to talk to you because I like you. I want you to look good out there. I want you to feel good. Okay, so when you step onto that red carpet, you know, don't give me a whole smile. You gotta give me a smize. Let me see your smize. There you go. See, you're smiling with your eyes. Don't let anybody tell you that you don't have it, because I can see you have it. Where's he going? We're just getting started. We didn't even get into, like, Botox for that furrow between your eyes there.
You know what they say, never work with kids or animals.
Yeah, you know what? Goose had him on the run, literally. Or was running away.
I don't know. But what I do know is we were so thankful to Marvel Contest of Champions for bringing moments like that directly to you, the fans. We're so thankful to them for presenting this live stream.
And you know what else Marvel's Contest of Champions is doing? They're actually commemorating the release of Marvel Studios' Captain Marvel by dropping some new stuff for users.
Oh, yeah. You're going to be able to play with Captain Marvel starting on March 7th and Nick Fury starting on March 21st.
But if you can't wait that long, because obviously Marvel's Contest of Champions is one of my favorite games, and I can't, tomorrow there is going to be a brand new event, Battle Realm Under Siege, where you're going to be able to play with Carol Danvers, Captain Marvel, and Nick Fury, and they're going to be on a mission to find out what's going on with an alternate universe Carol Danvers and what's behind her losing her memories.
And there might be a Skrull or two, I'm just saying.
I mean, Skrulls be scrolling.
All right, pick up the game. You can get it at the App Store or the Google Play Store. Stage at the other end of the carpet. What is going on, Lorraine and JD?
Oh, well, you know, we're just hanging out here with Gemma Chan.
Hi.
Just checking out the scene.
I
have to say, there is something that belongs to you on the set that you left here on the red carpet?
Well, I do fly a ship like that. I don't know if it is the ship that I flew, but it's pretty cool, huh?
Yeah, it's not bad. Kree dropship.
Now, Minerva is quite a character that you get to play. She's a marksman. She's incredibly intense. What was the best part of being a superhero?
Gosh, you know what? The best part was getting to learn a new skill. So when I found out that I was going to be playing her, I started doing kickboxing and boxing, which I'd never done before. And I got to go to sniper school and learn a few skills with the weapons, which was which is fun.
That sounds awesome. Also, I have to say, I saw you see Lashana Lynch across the carpet, and you were just like, sending love.
There she is, looking absolutely fantastic. Hello.
What was it like being around so many amazing women?
You know what, we joke that we're now like a girl band. Lashana, myself, and Brie. Like, move over TLC. I'm ready for BLG.
BLG, yeah. 90s BLG. Charts, get ready.
That works. That could be awesome.
You don't look
awesome.
That convinced. That's okay. That's okay.
You love it.
So from social media, we have a couple of questions for you.
Sure.
One is, what is your favorite part about your character? What did you like most about Minerva?
I love the fact that Minerva is fearless and she's loyal. She's pretty stubborn.
You know, I'm a little curious how she also feels about Vers.
Yeah, they're kind of frenemies. Can you say that? Yeah. Yeah.
All right. Some sibling rivalry, if you were related.
Yeah.
All right.
The other question people wanted to know is, what other Marvel superhero do you admire or would you like to be?
My goodness. You know what? I love Valkyrie. And I met Tessa Thompson the other day. First time. She's. I reckon Minerva and Valkyrie would have a good time together.
Oh, they would.
They'd go out on the town.
They would have a lot of fun.
They would.
They would.
I mean, they would. They kick a lot of butts.
I want to go to whatever party that is. Thank you so much for talking with us.
Thank you.
Enjoy
so much,
your
Gemma.
Night. You have so many more people to see, and we don't want to steal all your time. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thanks, guys.
So cheers. Gemma's just going to get in that spacecraft and take it off.
All right. Bring it back when you're done. I don't want to get in trouble for that.
I don't
that.
Want any dings on the ship.
Yeah, no. That's going up against my credit score.
Still
I can't take
that,
it.
It has that new dropship smell.
Yeah, it smells like fresh cream.
Phrase like challah in the springtime.
Oh, it smells like challah, and challah smells delicious.
Smells delicious, like a blueberry.
Oh, it does. Oh, speaking of Lashana Lynch. Blueberries? We're just talking about blueberries.
We're talking about blueberries.
Musical bloopers? I want them.
I have to say, I love Maria so much, and her friendship with Carol is beautiful. How did you and Brie start to build that rapport and find that relationship?
We just hung out. It was really easy. Honestly, it was so... Have you met Brie? She's a pretty cool chick. She's easy to get along with, and I think we just wanted the same things. We wanted to represent the modern-day women in the best form, and that's exactly what we did. We're just two women connecting on screen.
Both you and Brie play military women, and I know that was an important thing for both of you to get right.
Yeah.
And you both went up in F-16s and did a lot of some intense stuff. What was the hardest part about sort of getting that right and learning about that way of life?
I mean, doing everyone justice, they do a pretty incredible job, and we just wanted to represent them in the way that they deserve. And I hope that we've done that for them in this movie. We just have a newfound respect for what they do, and it's nice to be able to put that into a superhero movie and let the two marry well together.
And they really, really do. Now, I have to ask you potentially a very silly question, but I need to know, what is Maria's favorite 90s jam?
Oh, I think Maria's favorite 90s jam would be similar to mine. It would be any R&B girl group. So it'd be someone like 702, SWV, Jade, En Vogue, all of those songs that all of them have done would be my favorite and her favorite.
Done. The jam.
The En Vogue would be pretty great. And all of that would be pretty awesome. So when you were doing this with Brie, did you ever, I mean, Brie got into some intense shape doing this.
Did
you did you try to go head to head on stuff? Did you?
No, I don't really think we needed to do that. I definitely wasn't.
Brie's
speaking
right
of
here.
Which, hello, it is the belle of the ball right here, Captain Marvel. My goodness, Brie
there
Larson.
She is.
I just need to say to you, you two incredibly brilliant, powerful women standing up here. Right now, you are between the U.S. Air Force and the best fans in the whole wide
the best
world
man.
Of the best character. What does this moment feel like for you?
I don't know if I'm just tired, but I feel like I'm going to cry.
Let it out, girl.
Yeah, it's been a couple of years of working on this movie, and so this is really moving me. She's got the wig and everything.
Oh, my gosh.
It's really cool.
It really is so beautiful, and I see that beautiful shared experience with so many people. What has Carol meant to you? Because she means a lot to me, and I know she means a lot to so many people here.
I mean, Carol changed my life, and this movie hasn't even come out yet. Just in particular, getting strong and learning how to stand my ground and own myself and value my voice. Those are things that I learned from her, so I'm excited to share her with the world.
And the fans, I mean, they meet, Carol means so much to them, and it must mean a lot to you to see. Do you have you heard from people as you're just walking down the street, people saying what the character means to them, and you know, have they shared a little bit of their Carol love with you?
Only in moments like this. I haven't like walked down the street that much, and we've been like everywhere in the world right now.
Well, you walked down this street, Hollywood Boulevard.
Yeah, whatever this street that we've shut down. Yeah. These have been the moments where I've realized like that this is an important symbol, and it, like I said, she changed my life, so I'm excited to see what she can do to the rest of the world.
I love seeing you up here together. I think it's such a wonderful kismet that you guys are here right now. I would love to know what Carol loves about Maria and what Maria loves about Carol.
Go on, Brie.
Easy question.
She's fierce. She's so smart and capable and an incredible mother. And
they have an incredible competitiveness, but it's a playful competitiveness because they know that they're equals at the end of the day, and that's what I love.
She is honest with herself and with Maria. She is truthful to what she believes in. She fights for what she wants. She's crazy talented, Brie and Carol. And she's just all-round badass, and that's because she's a full-on modern-day woman. She's just a normal woman with incredible superpowers, both in her heart and both in her hands.
And I do think that is such a true superpower, the great heart that you both bring to the screen.
We were talking about this earlier before you walked up, but the military women here, they're a real inspiration. And I wanted you to talk a little bit about your meetings. You've met, obviously, with the first female fighter pilot in the Air Force.
Mm-hmm.
And talk about those encounters and how they inspired you. And
They're actually here tonight. Yeah. I got General Levitt's here and Kazi, who actually took me up in the plane. She's here tonight, too, along with some of the other women that I met while I was there. It was a game changer for me because I had read the comics and Carol's like fierceness and her wit, and also despite her being at times cocky, her humbleness too, all I thought was her. And then when I went to the Air Force, I realized that's the spirit of the Air Force inside of her.
Love that. Well, thank you both so much for talking with us. We can't steal all your time, but we would if we could.
I have one question that I forgot to ask, but I want to. Senator Martha McSally, Republican of Arizona, had a question for you.
Okay.
And that's, she wanted to ask about the training that you went through and what you learned about military life through that training. What was the most intense and meaningful part of it? And, you know, what was the best part?
It requires a complete dedication, and you have to really put your priorities towards it, and you really learn what you're made of. It changes your mind completely. I've been very open about the fact that I'm an introvert, I have asthma, and I was able to push myself further than I ever thought possible, and I think the reason why I'm able to like stand here and be the person that I am is through that training and through the teachers that I had. I had such great teachers on this.
Incredible.
Well,
wow.
Thank you, ladies, so much. Enjoy the carpet. This
thank
is your
you.
Night.
Enjoy.
Oh, my gosh.
I literally feel like that. It's our prom.
It's their prom, of course. Thank
well,
you so much,
have a great prom.
Ladies.
Enjoy
thank
that.
You. Thank you.
Okay. Oh, my gosh. You know, that's something that I love about this film is that Carol and Maria's relationship is so important to the film. It does have a large element of friendship that I think is so important.
And I think it's one of those unique relationships in comics, too, where you see a strong female friendship that's supportive, that is more and more the way these stories are being told, but they haven't been told that way for many, many years. So it's really exciting to see it reflected on the big screen.
Oh, my gosh. Hello. Hail to the chief.
That?
Hello, Kevin Feige is here with us. How are you doing, Mr. President?
I'm good. I don't know how to follow them, but I'm here.
I do want to say, you said this was the first film you were going to let your daughter see from the Marvel Cinematic Universe. Is that correct? Is she going to get to see this one?
She will certainly see it. Oh, yes. Yes, it won't be the first. She's caught up. She's 10
okay.
now, so she's seen a few. This one, though, I think she's most excited for.
I have to say, just being here with Brie, I was getting so emotional just talking to her. It means so much to me personally as a comic book fan. I know this means so much to so many girls, women, boys, men who love this character. Why did you feel like this was Carol's time?
It's been her time. It's been a long time coming. I think it was almost 4.5 years ago, which right over there in the El Capitan, we announced that we were doing this movie, that we're doing Carol Danvers' story. When we first met with Brie, my daughter was probably 5 or 6, and we said, one of the many reasons to make this movie, so she has someone to look up to. And now we're on the red carpet, and we're about to show the world the movie.
It's amazing.
Well, we should ask you, this is a bittersweet moment, because Stan Lee is no longer with us. He makes one of his classic cameos in this movie, and you obviously had a long relationship with him. I wondered if you could talk a little bit about his relationship to these movies, and you know, what this means, this moment with him not being
in the movie. It's sad. It feels like one of the first red carpets without him. This being the first Marvel Studios film released without him, you know, this film, frankly, we feel that all the films we've made is a tribute to his work, and we're always trying to do our best and do right by he and all of his co-creators. This one, though, particularly important as it's the first one. So, yes, his cameo. And this film sort of begins as a celebration to Stan and his legacy.
And the cameos themselves, people don't really know how that came about. A lot of people, diehard fans do, maybe know a little. But talk a little bit about how he began to appear in every single film.
My memory of it is that it started as a tradition on X-Men 1. That was the first time I was involved on it, where he was a hot dog vendor in X-Men 1. He had done a cameo before that. He was in the cartoons before that, of course, the comics. I think he made a cameo in the trial of the Incredible Hulk with Lou Ferrigno many years before. But through the X-Men movies, the Sam Raimi Spider-Man movies, it just became this amazing tradition, not just so the fans had something to cheer for during the movie and a way to pay tribute to him, but it became a holiday on set. It became a national holiday when he was around on set, up through this movie and an upcoming one as well.
Oh, I love Stan so much. He will be so incredibly, incredibly missed, I know, especially in the Marvel Cinematic Universe. But switching gears a little bit, I'm really curious why you decided to pull this film into the 90s, because I'm here for it.
It was something we hadn't done before. We wanted to explore this section of the MCU. We also wanted Carol to have her origin alter herself. We wanted to have this section of the MCU, the Kree-Skrull War from the comics, which we hadn't touched on at all up until this point, to have this entire section of the universe for her to inhabit before coming in and joining the rest of the team.
Well, thank you so much for talking with us.
Good seeing you. Thank you.
Nice to see you.
Good to see you. Enjoy your night. Oh, my gosh. The man right there. You know, so much amazing stuff comes out of Marvel Cinematic Universe because of Kevin Feige.
He's given birth to many, many remarkable stories. So it's great.
Indeed. You know, I have to say, Brie's training was so incredible.
Unbelievable. 9 months.
And, you know, I think we should take a look at a feature right now all about that.
We need heroes. We need you.
Captain Marvel is about somebody who goes on a journey of discovery. And I think it was really important for Brie to learn how to fight.
By the time we started shooting, I had been training for 9 months. And I'm glad that I did. Doing fight sequences up and down and training for 3 days felt kind of alive.
The thing that I found so unique about this character was that sense of humor mixed with total capability in whatever challenge comes her way.
You know how to fly this thing?
We'll see.
Which I realized after going to the Air Force base is really what Air Force pilots are like.
That's a yes or no question.
Yes.
We simulated a dogfight, we were on the offense, we were on the defense. We got to 6.5 Gs.
It was amazing.
It's a lot of work. She brings so much of that to the role. It's pretty awesome.
You know, I love it when she just smashes that lady's head into the pole there. It's pretty intense, right?
I mean, definitely. I just love seeing their arrival into the airport, or into the airport, into the air base.
Yeah.
Seeing them in those planes to me is very stirring. Something about seeing them in an F-16 is very powerful.
It's incredible to see. I mean, they're incredibly sophisticated machines, mm-hmm. and they, you know, there's several mm-hmm. tons of equipment, you know, flying around in the air like that. It's kind of incredible. Also, just to see the kind of shape that she got into, the things that she can do physically. And, you know, I love that mm-hmm. she says, you know, she was asthmatic and introvert, and she's able to do that. That's inspiring. We could all...
That speaks to me on a deeper level.
I mean, I don't think I'll ever be able to do some of those things, but I'd like to be able to think that I could.
I would love to push a Jeep. Also, I have to say the carpet right now is bustling. Everyone is arriving to see the film unspool in the classic Dolby Theater. The Dolby Theater where you were just here the other weekend.
I was just here the other weekend
for a
smaller event called the Academy Awards.
Yeah.
And what's exciting about that is, of course, Marvel's Black Panther mm-hmm. won 3 Academy Awards, the Academy Awards. Best costuming, best original score, and best original You know, that production other thing. Design. Production design.
For Hannah Beachler. Absolutely.
How
incredible.
I blank on that? That's embarrassing.
I mean, I have to
Hannah Beachler.
So well deserved. Warriors Fall, practical set. Like, I think it was 200 feet higher, 80 feet high. It was very high.
That's all
you need to know. But it sounds like Tamara and Angelique are down on the other end of the carpet. How are you ladies doing? What's going on?
What are they doing?
We are here with writer Kelly Sue DeConnick, whose run on Captain Marvel actually was some of the inspiration for the film tonight. How does it feel being here at the world premiere?
It's absolutely incredible. And I got the opportunity to actually work on the film, which was amazing. Yeah. And I'm so happy and so proud to have been involved in any small way. Yeah. And I'm here with my family and my kids. And my daughter is losing her mind. So that's kind of the greatest thing ever.
So let's talk about that for a minute. Okay. So I have an 8-year-old daughter, and for me, it is...
My daughter is 8? Is she here?
No, I'm working, so I don't get to bring her.
All right.
But that said, so having these 8-year-old girls who finally get to look up at the screen and see such a role model, what's that been like for you as a creator?
I don't think it's quite sunk in yet how big a deal it is. Mm. When I watched the first cut that I saw was still very much in progress, and I cried 3 times. And I'm not a weeper, you know? That's not.
I don't think of you as a weeper.
No, I mean, I cry when I get mad. If I get mad enough, I cry, and then I'm embarrassed, so then I get madder, and then more. It's very ugly. But
it's a cycle.
Yeah. I'm working on it. But. It was incredibly emotional. And then when we saw the first trailer that had a hero where they popped the her out, my daughter was with me at that moment, and I had a much stronger reaction to it than I thought I was going to. I have this tendency to be very, you know, cool and removed about everything, and that facade is over. I haven't got it, so.
I gotta admit, I am a huge fan of your Twitter. Tonight, if you had one thing to say about your feelings, what would it be on Twitter? Your tweet, what is it?
You know, Carol's sort of a person that lives in my head, you know, and she's lived in my head since about 2010. And I feel right now really proud of her. I feel like, look what you did, you know?
So proud. Yeah. I'm here for it.
Yeah.
And so also, you know, there's military background in your family. And one of the amazing things has been the involvement of the Air Force in this film. Yeah. So how has that felt to actually see that realized?
I was in the car when the flyover happened and, like, tears. So waterproof mascara is a good thing. My dad's retired Air Force. The second printing of the collection has, on the first printing, we missed being able to get the dedication in. Yeah. But the second printing has a dedication to my dad, who had suffered a stroke while I was working on the book.
Yeah.
So, it's very personal. These are pilots and Air Force people were my family. That's who I grew up with, you know?
Well, we want to thank you so much for taking the time out tonight to stop here. We know we got a lot of people you have a lot of other people to talk to. Thank you so much and for all your work.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much. Thank you, guys. All right, let's see what else is going on.
Yeah.
Oh, you know, we're just hanging out. I love that you talked to Kelly Sue DeConnick, though. I love her comics. A legend. Such an incredible creator. Such an incredible writer. And I think in a lot of ways that run on the comic, that when she made Carol step up as Captain Marvel, really changed that character forever. But you know, we should tell you guys how to watch this. If you want to check us out, go over to marvel.com/Captain Marvel Live, where you can check out this as well as articles and photos and more. You can also follow at Captain Marvel or the official Captain Marvel Facebook page.
And you can watch us on people.com and EW.com as well. So pretty exciting.
Yeah, so I mean, a million wonderful things.
A million places to enjoy Captain Marvel in a deep social way.
Indeed. You know, EW has an awesome MCU cover, don't they?
Yes, they do. In fact, EW has a special book, which is dedicated to Captain Marvel, has incredible art, photos, exclusives, cast interviews, incredible deep dive into all things Carol Danvers and her amazing world.
I always enjoy checking out those covers, and look at her in that costume. I mean, I love the classic flight suit. It really harkens back to her Air Force background. And, you know, it's the classic color, you know, that red, blue, and gold.
And as you said, it's sort of inspired by Chuck Yeager, by test pilots. It's a really sort of incredibly empowering look for a superhero, for certainly one that resonates deeply with her fans. Yeah. And you can see a lot of takes on her outfit tonight here on the red carpet.
And indeed, huge kudos to Jamie McKelvey, one of the original artists who worked on that costume, that worked with Kelly Sue DeConnick to come up with that flight suit. But, you know, it sounds like our cohorts are down on the carpet getting into fun without us. What are you ladies up to?
What are they up to?
We're just talking a little bit about Marvel Contest of Champions.
Just a little bit. I might have told some people they need to go download it just so they can play Carol very, very soon.
It's so inspiring seeing so many of the cast members here and hearing them talk about all the training that they did. So it kind of makes me get my hand on the game and do some kicks and some punches.
Go be a champion. You know what? You're already a champion in my heart, though. But we do want to say a very special thank you. Tonight's live stream, all the fun and amazingness that you've been seeing is brought to you, presented by Marvel's Contest of Champions. And I, for one, am happy that we get to be here.
I'm thrilled that we get to be here. And it's been really fun watching you guys talk with so many of the cast members. What's happening on your end of the carpet right now?
Well, I am utterly flabbergasted and honored to have Brigadier General Jeannie Leavitt here with us. Congratulations on getting to be a part of this film. What was it like getting to work with Brie?
It was wonderful. I really appreciated how interested she was in being very genuine in her character.
One of the most interesting things about your story is you really were at the spear point of change for women in the U.S. Air Force in terms of the roles you were able to take on. When you look back at the last, since more and more jobs have been open to women in the Air Force, what do you think of where women are going in the Air Force and actually throughout the military? Are you optimistic that even more roles will be open to them, combat roles and leadership roles?
I am very happy to see all the changes I've seen. I had great timing in terms of having the opportunity to go fly fighters before women had done that. And so it's great to see that all of these opportunities are available to women now. And when they join our team, they become part of something special.
That really does show so well, I think, especially in the film. I'm curious, what does it take to be a good fighter pilot, besides maybe a strong stomach?
Well, you've got to have grit, determination, and you've got to be able to think really fast.
I like it. I felt a little chill. Maybe yeah. I'm cold, but I was also very chilling.
Yeah, it is cold here tonight, but it is incredible to meet somebody who's really done such incredible work for our country and has really led the way for women in the military, in fact, for all pilots in the military. We're going to lead into a wonderful piece about the contribution of our veterans and of our wonderful members of the Air Force.
Thank you so much. Enjoy the film tonight.
Thank you.
The Air Force is such a huge part of this movie. We wanted to take a moment to spend some time with some real servicemen and women who are joining us here tonight at the premiere.
And I think it's absolutely amazing because there are so many superheroes we're going to see tonight, but we get to talk with some heroes right here on the red carpet.
Absolutely. Thank you guys so much for being here. So for you, what does it mean to see Captain Marvel up on the real screen, Carol Danvers, member of the Air Force?
I think it's pretty cool. It's like we're being represented by someone who plays and portrays us as someone amazing, you know, and we don't get that recognition often, so I think it's nice to see it on the big screen.
And I know that folks always kind of ask, why the Air Force? Why would the military, and I know you have a reason for why the Air Force. All of you are looking at me like, that's why, because what other branch would we go and serve in? But, you know, everyone's got their origin story, and we're going to see Carol Danvers' origin story tonight. What's yours?
Oh, my story. It's just a humble beginning. Just
the poorest country in the world and becoming part of the greatest nation and had a chance to be part of the greatest military on earth and to just see us being captured on the screen, what she does and what we do in real life. And it's phenomenal. Yeah.
One of the reasons that her performance is so great on the screen is because of all the amazing training that she went through. And I know you all have gone through some incredible training. Can you talk for a moment about what the everyday training is like in the Air Force?
Oh, well, first, of course, we have basic training, which we are in the customs and courtesies and the do's and don'ts and how not to get in trouble. And then we also have tech training where we learn our jobs and more customs and courtesies, but it's a little more laid back. And we just learned that we are just like everybody else, except for we decided to serve our country and protect those that just are citizens and to just uphold the Constitution, really.
Well, thank you so much for your service, and thank you for being here tonight for the red carpet premiere of Marvel Studios, Captain Marvel. All right, back to the red carpet.
What an inspiration. This entire night, it's just been so beautiful to share this, not only with our fans, but our incredible people here from the U.S. Air Force. It's been incredible.
Well, I think what's important is to recognize their service and the contribution they make every day. I think it's really nice to see how all the actors really appreciated the expertise, the service, the what it takes as a member of the military and as a member of a military family to undergo that kind of service and sacrifice. I also want to say, Hannah Beachler, I stumbled on her name because we were moving fast and furious here, and she is an amazing production designer who most certainly deserves an Oscar.
I know, and we have so many incredible women working on this film, behind the scenes as well as in front of the cameras. I think that's one of the things that's really excellent to see in this film is all of the contribution from all over.
You know, and I think it's a real moment in the Marvel Universe when you're getting to see, you know, people talk a lot about a female-driven film. Mm-hmm. There have been a lot of strong characters in the Marvel Universe. This movie is not just female-driven. The makers of the film, people who collaborated on the film, were a lot of them incredibly accomplished women, and we'll be still here tonight.
Well, I heard a scream, so I think we have to check in
I think so. That's why I stumbled there again. Let's see what is going on.
I know. There's always so much excitement, but what kind of exciting things are you guys doing down there on the carpet? Let's check in with Angelique and Tamara.
See what they're doing.
We are joined here on the carpet with two agents of S.H.I.E.L.D., here with Henry Simmons, who plays Alfonso Mack McKenzie, as well as the amazing Natalia Cordova Buckley, who plays Elena Yo-Yo Rodriguez. How are you doing this evening?
We're doing good. Excited to be here. Support Marvel and Brie as the first superhero, female superhero. I'm very excited to see the movie. Yeah.
So we've got a couple changes coming up this season. Director Mack.
Yeah.
A little job title change. So I'm curious, going into this, what do you think makes Mack a good director, and what are we a little worried about for his leadership capabilities?
You know, I think the thing that makes me a good director is the thing that could also hinder me as a director. I think Mack wants to do the right thing and do the thing that is truthful and what's best for the overall. But sometimes you can't do what's best for everyone. You have to do what's best for particular people.
Absolutely.
Right? Yeah, it's tough. You have to send people into harm's way, and that can be a difficult decision at times, right?
Absolutely. Like this woman here, I mean, I got to send Yo-Yo in, you know what I mean? I don't want to do that.
And I mean, last season was a little, like, Yo-Yo went through it last season. Yeah. But it seems like Yo-Yo is back in action and ready to get at it. What are we expecting out of this next chapter in Yo-Yo and maybe Yo-Yo Mack's lives?
A lot changes in season 6 for Yo-Yo and Mack. And I think losing her arms was a big deal in why those shifts happened. She becomes a little bit tougher, you know. Her arms become robot, and I think a part of her, she doesn't lose. She's hardened, for sure. Yeah.